And I stay committed with sharing to you ideas on how we can convert our homes into schools, as the pandemic is causing problems with reopening our learning mediums, the typical ones. And since we are the first line of defense and unit on how we can actually impart lessons of how we could be successful in life and teach our kids how to do so, I'll be sharing to you some tips there so we can actually use it as adults too in a different way. First off is learning how to thrive in struggles, because kasama na sa buhay natin yan, mga besh, ang mga pagsubok. At minsan, uncomfortable tayong i-face yung mga challenges na yan. So, we have this marshmallow test. If you're familiar with it, you can try your kids' favorite dessert, like chocolate, at sabihin sa kanila na, meron akong nilagay sa table na isang piraso ng tsokolate. Pag hindi mo siya kinain hanggang sa sinabi ko na pwede na siyang kainin, bibigyan kita ng mas marami pang chocolates. So that's a reward system. It teaches kids patience and seeing their goals, yung future goals in comparison sa short-term feeling of satisfaction. So when we start them young, learning how to be patient about challenges, they become more successful. And actually, the children who were actually able to survive this test were checked after a couple of years. And yung mga sumunod na hindi kinain yung marshmallow, kasi marshmallow talaga yon, at nung nabigyan sila ng reward after na hindi nila kinain, yun yung mga naging successful na kids in comparison dun sa mga hindi nakatiis at kinain na yung marshmallow dahil hindi na nila caring, intayin na pwede na siyang kainin. So as adults, we can actually give ourselves the challenge of the reward system. Say for example, ako kasi, I really hate technology. So I can actually try to give myself a reward system by saying, okay Jesse, pag inaral mo to at in-apply mo, nagawa mo yung task ng learning at application ng technology that you can use for your work and your passions, bibigyan kita ng whole day, rest day with a spa or a salon where you can beautify yourself and relax the whole day. Yung mga ganyan. So, failures and challenges are a part of life, and it's actually a good medium for us to learn and appreciate life better, which is why this is something that we should really understand, that it's something that needs to be celebrated instead of being feared of, because we have constant battles and exposure to pressures. May mga magulang na ayaw na ayaw nilang makaranas yung mga anak nila ng mga masasakit na experiences, which is why they try so hard to protect their kids from experiencing these things, when in fact they will learn more if they get exposed to challenges when they're younger. So pag naging adult na sila, mas mafe-face nila yung mga challenges the best manner possible. So yun, obviously nagbibinata na naman po ako, mga kaibigan, pumabalik na tayo sa medyo semi-new normal, kaya ang workload ko ngayon ay medyo at its peak, and I'm very grateful for the opportunity. So that's one challenge that I constantly face, and I'm grateful for it, and I'm having fun. So yun, if we have the proper mindset of thinking na yung mga pagsubok na yan ay mas nagbibigay ng spice o ng saya at mas marami tayong natututunan habang nasasaktan tayo at tumitibay tayo sa mga pagsubok, mas na-appreciate nating mabuhay. Kahit na maraming marami tayong pagdaanan, nagiging story siya ng buhay natin in a positive way if we have the right mindset. Second is teaching our kids to be intrigued with mistakes. Yung curiosity mo na magkamali at sumubok ng panibagong paraan para ma-achieve mo yung goals mo is actually a fun experience instead of having the feeling of rejection. So, tayo bilang magulang, it's our obligation to let our kids understand that failing is okay. That we may not be able to achieve our goals the first time, but what really matters is if we try and try and try and try unlimited until we succeed. So you can actually use exercises for your kids, like yung pag-form ng Lego or yung shapes and sizes. Kasi, di ba, para malaman nila na ang triangle pala ay hindi sasuwak sa bilog. Sa yung mas malaking size ng bilog ay hindi magkakasya sa mas maliit na bilog. Yung mga ganyang exposure nila sa mistakes will actually teach them the right way to do it and cheer them on as they fail, so they understand that failing is just a process of learning and there's no shame to committing mistakes, diba? Let's make it a fun experience for our kids so they don't get traumatized from committing mistakes one after the other. So for us adults as well, the proper mindset of realizing that mistakes are actually helping you to learn more in life and eventually succeed is a proper way of, you know, embracing failures, embracing that we are human beings and we're not perfect and we're good as we are, no matter how much we fail. Yung mga ganitong mga lessons that some parents usually fail to address because gaya sa point system ng schools, usually we get to compare one kid from another, kaya meron tayong mga honorable mentions, best in math, best in science, valedictorians, blah, blah, blah. Because the level of excellence we impose on children is if they're doing better than the other kids, which is doing it the wrong way at one point, because it actually is straining the kids' confidence. Kasi tayo, meron tayong sari-sariling core gifts. Say, for example, I am good in a specific subject, in communication, in sharing my views, in teaching others on how to lead better lives. And that's my core gift. If I focus on mathematics and get stuck on that when, in fact, I'm not good at it, or strive my hardest to get A grades on all subjects, even if I suck at it, like not really good with physical education, tapos i-push ko yung sarili ko, hindi ko makikita yung rightful progress for me because that's not my gift. So let's help our kids and ourselves realize kung ano talaga yung blessing na meron tayo, yung kung ano yung talent na ibinigay sa atin, and focus on that and let our kids know that it's okay if we do not excel in each and every area because that's how life is, and that we should always look at the best version of ourselves, compare our old self to our new selves, yung improvement ng anak mo from learning 1 plus 1 hanggang sa natuto siya ng 10 plus 10, those little progress is something that we need to celebrate without comparing your kid to another child who excels better in mathematics or any other subject. For them to be able to realize that they're good as they are, what they bring to the table is enough. In the same manner as we adults should realize that it is highly important for us to recognize our strengths and embrace our weaknesses. And it's okay to excel in one area and not on others. Yung mga ganung factors. So I hope that this video actually taught you things wherein you can help your kids learn at home and encourage them to be the best version of themselves. So we can create a better today's, a better generation, and better tomorrows. You have yourself a wonderful day. Bye.